The canoe was safe there, too. No one goes down the new load, and Mort probably didn't even know that Lon sometimes hangs about Ferry House. He had satisfied himself that Lon's boathouse was completely hidden from chance observation. Then I think his idea may have been, when he went back to the canoe and pushed it off, that it would drift much farther, below the island, perhaps go over the weir, and he thought that would completely confuse the trail. Yes, I see. Very neat. But if Mort planned this beforehand, he ran it pretty fine, the whole time schedule, I mean. I'm pretty sure he didn't plan it ahead. In fact, I'm not sure yet that he's guilty of murder. I'm trying to see some point that may be evidence of that, one way or the other. Of course, concealing what happened and all that gives ground enough for an arrest. The evidence of those books, Wise remarked, indicating the two passbooks and the red notebook, gives motive enough for murder, to my way of thinking. It may show that he had reason to dislike and fear her, said Braden slowly. I shouldn't expect him to be the kind of man to knock a woman over the head. But it's conceivable that if he merely threatened, or perhaps pushed her, she may have fallen backwards into that narrow channel and struck her head on one of those stakes on the opposite side. He paused. I don't know. It may be a weakness, but I like to know what I really believe a man to be guilty of before I arrest him.
Dr. Odell entered with his report.
Those hairs on the trousers, he announced. There's more than one. Are as certainly the twin brothers of the hairs on Miss Denning's head as you can ever tell. Of course, no one can prove their identity one way or the other, he added helpfully.